Right, hello everyone. This is part two then of our superhero yoga sequence. So if you're clicked on this first, you need to go back to the YouTube channel and find part one, which was the warm up. This is going to be the main part of our yoga sequence where we go through some of the poses that we're doing for our superhero training today. Again, just make sure that you are in a safe space, that you've moved anything out of the way, that you've told a grown-up or an adult around you that you are going to be doing your yoga, listening to the instructions really carefully, and then having a go, and hopefully we'll have a little bit of fun whilst we're going through this, and hopefully I'll be able to see some of your yoga skills when we're all back together again, our green fingers. So, first thing we've done is we've done our breathing to warm up our brains, we've done some stretching to warm up our bodies, and now we're going to go through some of the poses. But I thought first of all we come all the way up to standing because we're going to start standing today. So the first one that we're going to do today in our superhero sequence is our flash. Now a flash is super fast and super quick, so we are going to do some super quick high knees running on spots to really get our bodies nice and warm, ready for the rest of our yoga. So, are you ready with me? Make sure you're in a safe place, that you're not going to bump into anything, and we're going to stay on the spot to do this, so we're not going to run around the room and bump into anybody. We'll stay on our mat or in our safe yoga space. So, 30 seconds of really quick, fastest running that you can possibly do. On your marks, get set, go! Running, quick as you can. Get those knees nice and high. Move those arms. And maybe run around on the spot. Quick as you can, white flash. Quick. Might be starting to feel a little bit tired now. Keep going. Don't stop. A few more seconds. Running. And 3, 2, 1, and stop. Well done, that was some really good, really quick running to get ourselves warmed. So if you're like me, you might put your hands on your chest and feel that your heart is beating a little bit faster now, and your breathing has got a little bit quicker, and you're feeling a little bit warmer. So that's really good, that means your body is getting ready to do some more exercise. So the next one that we're going to do is superheroes need to be strong, they need to be fast, and they need to be brave. So we've done our running, like the flash, to be super, super fast. Now we need to get strong. So to be strong, we're going to do some strong Hulk poses. So we're going to pretend to be the Hulk. So taking our feet nice and wide on the mat, we're going to have our feet pointing slightly out to the side, and we're going to sink our bottom all the way down and pull your big strong Hulk pose and give me a big loud Hulk smashing roar. After 3, everybody, 1, 2, 3, roar! Wow, done. Brilliant roaring, everybody. And can we hold this for a little bit longer? Being really, really strong, using all of our super hero strength. And then up we come. Well done, that was fantastic. Hulk yoga, being strong. And those roars were pretty terrifying. So well done, you gave me a scare. Right, next we need to be brave. So to be brave, we're gonna come into our Warrior One pose. Brave like Iron Man. So our Iron Man pose, we're gonna leave our left leg behind us, and we're going to step our right leg forward. So we're wide on our mat, and if you can see, my right leg, my toes are pointing forwards, and on my left leg, my toes are pointing out to the side in the direction I'm facing. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to face forwards, so I'm facing towards my right foot, and I'm going to lean forwards. So I might need to spread your legs a little bit wider on the mat. I don't know if I can fit all the way in. So I've got my knee over my ankle, and I'm stretched out with one on my mat. And then I'm going to take my arms And just like Iron Man, I'm going to shoot some lasers out the front of my hands. Are you ready? Shooting those lasers out the front of your hands like Iron Man. Well done. And then we're going to come back up to the middle. And then we're going to go the other way. So we're swapping legs this time. So left leg's going to be at the front. Stepping that arm forward. Bending that front knee. So we've got a nice bend here. So we've got our knee over our ankle. And we're going to stretch forward and shoot some lasers in the other direction like Iron Man. So taking your arms out wide, and we're going to go. Shooting those lasers out forwards. And I don't know if you can see my hands, but they're stretched really, really wide as I'm shooting those lasers forward like Iron Man. And then we're going to come all the way back up to centre and move our feet back to the middle. So that's our Iron Man pose. So you can have a go at that, swapping from leg to leg. You can pause the video and have a go, or you can rewind and go back and have another look and then have another try. Then after we've done our Iron Man, we are going to do some jumping like Spider-Man, who jumps from building to building. So he needs to be really, really brave, because I don't know about you, but I'm a bit scared of heights. So to do some of our jumping, we're going to do some really big jumps. We're going to take our legs again, a little bit wide on the mat. We're going to bring our bum all the way down this time, placing our hands in front of us. And we're going to do some big leaps all the way up to the ceiling. So I'm going to count to three and we're all going to jump together. And we're just going to do one jump to begin with, have a practice. And then we'll have a go doing some more. So are you ready? Big Spider-Man leap all the way up to the sky. One, two, three, jump! All the way up and all the way back down. Well done. That was an amazing Spider-Man leap. Gosh, I can't believe you guys got that high. That's incredible. Right, so let's have a go. This time we're going to do three, one after the other. So we need to make sure that we land really carefully so that we're not wibble wobbling all over the place, that we land on our 2 feet and come all the way back down so our hands are on the floor. Okay, you ready? Three big leaps to the sky. After three, one, two, three, one, two, and three. Wow, gosh, those were massive Spider-Man leaps. I bet you'd be getting halfway across Worcestershire with those leaps if you were Spider-Man. That's fantastic, well done. So, we've done some Spider-Man leaps, we've done some Iron Man warrior poses, we've done some Hulk super strong smashing. I think now we might need to do some Batman hanging upside down. So to be Batman, Batman lives in a cave and bats hang upside down from caves. So to be Batman, we're going to come all the way back up to standing, take our feet nice and wide on our mat, and we're going to just bend from our hips all the way forward to see if we can get our head to hang all the way down. So we're hanging upside down, and if we can, we can take our fingers through our legs behind us and really hang upside down. I'm going to stay here for a few seconds, and then as we breathe in, we're going to come all the way back up to standing. Wow, we're done. Gosh, you must be so strong to hang upside down like Batman. Incredible. Shall we try that once more? See if we can hang a little bit longer upside down. You ready? Take a nice deep breath in. And then as we breathe out, we bend. Coming all the way upside down, taking our hands down to the floor, hanging all upside down. Wow, can you see all the way behind you? You can see the wall behind me. There's not much there. And then as we breathe in, we come all the way back up to standing. My gosh, you guys must be so strong now doing all those poses. Next one that we're going to do is we're going to fly like Superman. Now this is one of my favourites. I love this pose because it feels so cool flying through the air. So I'm going to turn sideways so you can see, but we're going to do it on each foot. So I'm going to start on my left foot first.
and place that foot really firmly down into the floor. And then I'm going to take my right leg up behind me. And as my right leg lifts, the front of my body goes forward. And it's like a pivot. So I'm going up and down. And you might need to really work on your balance to do this, because it's a really tricky pose. So, a secret that I tend to tell people is, if you want to keep your balance, find a point on the wall and just stare at that. So there's a plant on my shelf over there, and I'm staring right at that plant the whole time to help keep me balanced. So let's see if I can do it. Look forwards, concentrate, lifting my back leg, keeping my arms by my side. Okay, I've got my balance. And then I'm gonna push my arms out forward and shoot through the sky like Superman. And can we hold it for 10, shall we see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well done. Incredible, flying through the sky like Superman. And now we've done it on the one side, we're going to have a go at doing it on the other side. Now sometimes it's easier on one side than the other, so you might find it you're a bit more wobbly on one side than the other, and that's fine. If you can't hold it for 10 seconds, don't worry. Just gently put your foot down, because we don't want you to tumble and fall. And then just, when you're ready and you've got your balance again, have another go and try and pick it back up. So shall we try and have a go on our right side this time? So we're going to place our right foot down onto the floor. We're going to take a deep breath. Find something on the wall opposite to look at. And once that, we are really steady, really straight. We're going to lift that back leg. And then I'm now looking down at the floor, so I've moved my gaze from the wall just to help me keep my back nice and straight. And now when I've got my balance, I'm going to shoot my arms out forward like Superman. And I'm going to try and hold it again for 10 seconds. But don't worry if you wobble and fall, it just takes practice, okay? So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh my gosh, that was fantastic flying through the sky. I wonder what you guys saw on your journey. I was whooshing through all the clouds, right up in the sky, really high. I could see fields below me, I could see buildings, I could see some animals in the fields. So when you do your flying through the sky, perhaps you can have a think about all the wonderful things that you might be able to see. Right, and then we're going to finish finally with our last yoga pose. So this is another balancing one, a little bit tricky. And again, we're going to come all the way up to standing. So, remember at the beginning I said that superheroes need to be brave, they need to be strong, but they also need to be kind, because they help people. They help people that are in danger, and also they need to be kind to people that aren't so kind to everybody else. So, kindness is really important to be a superhero. So we're going to think about maybe Wonder Woman being kind, and to do that we're going to come to standing. We're going to put both our feet on the floor just a little bit apart, and we're going to come to our tree pose, which is a really good pose to keep us all centered and to help us focus our minds and think about all the kind things that we can do. So to do our tree pose, bring our hands to our heart center, and you can do it in three ways. You can either have your foot to the side of your ankle, balance there like that, so your toes are still touching the floor a little bit, and your knees out to the side. Or if you want to make it a little bit trickier, you can maybe bring your foot off the floor and rest your foot on the inside of your calf. Again, the knee pointing out to the side, so your hips are facing forward and your knee goes out and your hands are together at the heart center. If you can do that and you want to make it even more difficult, you can try and bring your leg all the way up and place your foot on the inside of your thigh. The only place I don't want it to go is across your knee, so it needs to go below your knee or above your knee. And again, hands at heart centre. want to leave your eyes open and focus at something to keep your balance while you think about that kind thought, then you can do that. And once you've got that thought in your head, take a deep breath and sigh it away and lower your leg all the way back down to the floor. And then we're going to do it on the other side. So, on the other side, we're going to pick up our foot and either have it on the inside of our ankle, so our toes are still touching the floor, bring it up to our calf, or bring it all the way up to the inside of our thigh. Okay, get your balance, make sure you're nice and straight and tall. And this time, we're going to think of one kind of thing that we can do later on. So it might be that you might want to help do the washing up after dinner, that would be kind. You might want to tidy your bedroom. You might want to do a bit of homework that you've not done yet. You might go and pick some flowers, if you're allowed, if you've got permission, because it's not okay to go out and just pick wild flowers. You must get permission. And go and give those flowers to a neighbour or to somebody who might be feeling a little bit sad. But you might want to go and read to a brother or a sister or a friend. You might want to share a toy with somebody or ask somebody to play a game. So whatever it is that's kind that you think might help somebody today, I want you to think about now as you're trying to stand in your tree pose. Because in our tree pose we're really grounded and we're trying to be kind to others. Well done. Have you thought about that? And take a deep breath in and then lower our foot down to the ground. Well done. So that's our superhero poses for today. And you might want to go back and have a look at them again and maybe just try one or two of them. You might want to just think of one that you really like doing and thought, oh gosh, that was really tricky. Maybe I want to get a little bit better at that. Maybe you might choose to practice that one a little bit. But all of them are really, really good for being brave, strong, and kind, which are important characteristics, important qualities for our superheroes. Okay, so this is section two or part two of our yoga superhero training finished. And then I'm going to pause this video here, or stop it here, and then I'm going to start another video, which will be part three, and we'll finish with a nice relaxation and maybe a little bit more breathing at the end. Okay, because after all that hard work we've just done, we definitely need to be able to lie down and have a rest and put our feet up. Okay, so have a look back on the YouTube channel and see if you can find part three, and I'll see you in a second for part three of our yoga superhero training.